What's good? It's your girl TJ. Today I'm back with another video for you guys. I'm going to show you guys how I got this honey blonde color in regards to the bundles I have. We're starting off with sunburn hair. The hair I have is their Peruvian straight. I have three bundles of 20 inches and then I have a 18 inch closer. So yeah, what you want to do is make sure your area is very secure, so put down trash bags or whatever, and you're gonna need a bowl and you're gonna need a mixer, and you're also gonna need some developer and also some bleach. Now this is a bleach I used to use before and it definitely never lift past like a chocolate brown, so yeah, I wouldn't recommend that. I would recommend the BW2. It lifts quickly and you won't have to leave that on there for a long time. So yeah, I take 3 scoops and a half, I believe, and take some developer, and we're gonna go ahead and mix it in. Now y'all probably saying, why is she using like an icing thing for the cakes to stir this up? I feel like with those type of mixing thing, it actually gets all the product, and when you like wipe off the side, this actually added into the bowl, if that makes any sense. I feel like it's not being wasted, and it's just my personal preference. You can use what they recommend in the beauty store, or whatever you may like, but I'm just stirring up until it gets to the consistency that I like, and then I'm gonna take it and I'm just gonna work my way up, starting from the bottom. Now you guys see I do have the hair in the bundle. It's just a way that's easier to me to do it, and I do like it. So after I go ahead and put everything on, I do take a brush, and the brush is like a hard brush that you would get from the beauty supply store, and you're just gonna brush through the hair with the bleach on there. I do feel like when you brush it through, it actually saturates each strand of the hair, and I feel like it just helps it process better and make sure everything is like evenly coated. Coated. So yeah, that is something you don't have to do, but I do that, and I feel like it processes evenly and gets every strand. So yeah, once you do that, you're gonna want to flip it over and make sure you detangle as well on the other side. So I'm just combing through the hair, and then I'm gonna start, you know, placing more bleach on this side as well. So that's a very, very important factor in doing bleaching. Well, just dyeing hair in general, making sure that each strand of hair is thoroughly saturated with the bleach. And with the BW2 bleach, I realized that it processes very, very quickly, and I really like that. Like I was saying before, that other bleach that I had, when you guys was like, why do you leave the bleach on the hair so long, it was because it was never lifting and I didn't know the difference between the two. So I had to do my research, and if you want like blonde hair, any type of blonde, like I don't know my blondes offhand, but you know, platinum or whatever type of blonde you would like, you would need to go ahead and get the BW2 bleach. But yeah, what I'm doing, I'm just going inside the bundle and getting the areas that I didn't, I couldn't get to from the outside. And you do have to be aware, you have to go inside if you're keeping it in the little wrapping thing, because you know, you might have some black strands up there if you don't go on the inside. So yeah, just brushing through. We're gonna let that process for about 30 to 35 minutes. This is what it looks like. That is good enough for me. I was just going left like for a honey blonde. So yeah, we're taking that to the sink and we're rinsing out all that bleach. So you wanna, this is a very important step. You wanna make sure you get all that bleach out, or it's gonna continue to process, and that could be very, very deadly. So I'm just using lukewarm water and I'm just rinsing that. Now to tone down like the ashiness or the brassiness of the blonde, I do go in with the Shimmers Light Shampoo. This is my favorite shampoo of all time to use to shampoo and tone down the brassiness of the blonde. So I do love this step. You can leave it on for however you like. I think it says 2 to 3 minutes, and that's what I do. So yeah, it's it. So now we're gonna go ahead and rinse that out, and we're about to go ahead and condition. I always use my sulfate free conditioner from Shea Butter, I believe. This is my favorite conditioner, and it also makes your hair very, very soft. I do use another conditioner as well, the tea tree oil from Sally's Beauties. Y'all, that stuff is bomb right there, but this is an alternative and it's just as good as that as well. So yeah, I'm just combing out the hair, and basically you want to let that sit, rinse it out, and you're all done. Now this is the closure part. Yeah. I did the closure a little bit differently because I did want it like a chocolatey brown. So I did start at the bottom. And as far as my mixture, as you guys, you see crumbs in there. I didn't really mix it up to like a creamy consistency because I wanted the hair to not process as fast. So I know that I had to add more powder than developer to get this type of consistency. So it does look like it's very creamy, but it's actually not. And I learned that when you do it this way, it doesn't process as fast as if you mix it all up until there's no like powder being seen. So I just do the same method, go ahead and then coat the front. I go ahead and brush it through, and you know, we gonna flip it over. And as you guys can see, it is processing, but not as fast as it would if I had mixed the mixture all the way through. So I'm just combing it, and I'm gonna repeat the same steps. Now, as far as the closure, I couldn't really show you guys how I was getting the roots of the closure because I didn't have a proper method. I didn't think about, you know, pinning it on my blockhead and doing it. It would have been so much easier to do, but y'all know it still turned out bomb anyway. So after I did that, I went ahead and made a more sticky consistency where it wasn't falling off the icing thing. And you know, I used that to bleach the knot, and I used this method and it came out like this. So I really like how the hair turned out. I hope you guys did too. And yeah, I'll talk to you guys in my next video.